My name is Terry Fostvedt, and I'm a language arts teacher at Centaurus High School in Colorado.
My name is Kirsten Aarestad, and I teach at Vantage Point High School in Adams 12.
I'm Tom Thorpe. I teach at Graland Country Day School in Denver, Colorado.
My name is Pam Richer. I teach social studies at Manual High School, 10th grade U.S. history, and 11th grade world history.
My name is Mark Delgado. I am a social studies teacher at Abraham Lincoln High School in DPS.
I've been a teacher for 16 years, and I've been a facing history teacher probably for the last three, after doing week-long seminar, Holocaust and Human Behavior, which was great.
This is my third year as a facing history teacher.
I was introduced to facing history about 3 years ago.
Everybody who's been exposed to facing history loves it.
I was so impressed with the quality of the instructional strategies that were offered and the materials that I immediately began infusing some of them into my classes. I teach English, and so one of the things I like to do is establish a historical context for literature. Since no literature is written in a vacuum, I think it's important for students to understand the kind of things that are happening in the world when a piece of literature is created.
As far as English is concerned, it almost has this social behavioral bent to it, but I really appreciate the idea that kids can really understand their own role in their history and that they themselves are creating their own history, so that they can go out and look at stories in the news, stories in their families, stories in the community, stories in the school, and say, this is where I fit, and this is what I should be doing, this is what I shouldn't be doing. And just having a more critical eye, a critical opinion as to who they are and what role they play in society.
Facing History has equipped me with pedagogical strategies and tools to make history seem more real, more connected to the student, not just an abstract name from a textbook.
Facing History has allowed me to feel comfortable with the content in the curriculum, but then also it has made me feel comfortable with bringing in this deeper side of the morality, of the ethics, of juxtaposing who a student thinks he or she is with the curriculum in a really free, a way that is very empowering for students.
We are performing a political act when we teach in getting students to engage with issues that are bigger than themselves.
We have to face it. We have to actually look into it before we can figure it out. So facing history to me is an act of participation in whatever and whoever we've become. Whether we're looking at the Holocaust, whether we're looking at the civil rights movement, whether we're looking at homophobia, whether we're looking at identity crises, where we fit, we have to face it. We have to be a portion and a participant in our own society. I love the name Facing History because it actually gives an active participation into history.
Facing History has given me, like, you could say, like, more tools in the toolbox, but they're really good tools. You know, you're using a ton of primary source documents. Kids are writing, reading. The material's really varied. There's, you know, music stuff. There's video pieces. Kids are doing something different with the historical material, and they're constantly reflecting, why is this important today? How does this affect me? What's a similar circumstance? I think it's constantly personalizing the history. I do notice that on the days that I'm using Facing History, the kids are more engaged. They connect to the material a lot. I think it, like, sticks with them.
I was looking for something that would revitalize my teaching, and I feel like Facing History has really done that. I found my philosophical home with the Facing History, with the teachers I've met, with the people in the organization. I just feel like it's made such a profound impact on my teaching, and I truly do feel like I have have found sort of a soulmate with Facing History. I love teaching Facing History.